every day in the United States, 10,000 people turn 65, and the number of older adults are going to more than double over the next several decades. Wow, that's a lot. I read an article that said 70% of 65-year-olds will need some long-term support before they die, but they really have not done any planning. They think their kids are going to take care of them or their grandchildren, which who knows if that's true, but if it is, it's going to take lots of people out of the workplace. So question is, I see there's a big request for home and community-based services to help older adults and individuals. Could you just tell us how this funding is going to be used and the Biden administration concept?
Absolutely. For those of us who are baby boomers, we see the value in having our government believe that we have to continue that or have that continuity of care. We are going to try to make sure this president and this administration are making major investments to try to make sure that caregivers of some of our family members are able to stay where they are and make a living as well. And so whether it's providing $550 million for home and community-based services, which is, by the way, an increase of about $158 million over the previous fiscal year, we are making sure that we make those types of opportunities available to families. We want to make sure that older Americans continue to receive access to the nutrition that they've come to rely on when it's hard for them to afford it. And so we make additional investments in some of those nutrition programs for our seniors. And we continue to make every effort to try to make sure that everyone who is under the age of 65 and doesn't yet qualify for Medicare can qualify to have access to healthcare, whether it's through the Affordable Care Act exchanges or perhaps through some of the proposals that the president is gearing up that would help a lot of our older Americans who are not yet Medicare eligible have access to the kind of care that they need. I could go into more details, but you and I know the importance of Meals on Wheels for so many seniors, but it's also making sure that those caregivers that some of our older Americans rely on are actually able to do the work and afford to keep that as a living.
Thank you. I yield back, Madam Chair.